Welcome back again to my channel Learn Electronics. Please like, share and subscribe my channel. Today we are going to see a frequency shift keying, one of the keying method used in a communication circuits. So this FSK is the frequency modulation system. So in that frequency modulation system, digital information is transmitted, but it transmitted like a discrete frequency. So it will change the carrier wave according to our digital information. So this technology is used in a communication system, as I say so, in case of radio, in case of cellular ID, in case of situations like broadcast, we can use FSK. This simple FSK is also called as BFSK. We also call it as a binary phase shift keying. So what is binary phase shift keying? It uses a pair of discrete frequency to transmit binary numbers, zeros and ones. So this information, called it as a binary information, is transmitted as a frequency. So with this scheme, the one is called as a mark frequency and the zero is called as a space frequency. So two frequencies simultaneously, for one called as a mark frequency and for zero it's called as a space frequency. So you can see the time domain of FSK modulated carrier wave. This is the data. We can say the input, as this is called as a 1 and this is called as a 0. So this is the carrier signal. We can say the frequency is same throughout the signal. While in case of this is the modulating signal, it is called as FSK signal. So where we can see here, for 1 the frequency is shifted like this, we can call it as a mark frequency, and for 0 we can say the frequency is like this, it is called as a space frequency. This is a socket used to generate FSK. So here the output will be FSK signal, where there will be mark and space frequencies depending upon the input digital data. So that input digital data may be square waveform, which having like 0, 1, 0, 1 and so on. So this data is fed to this transistor. This transistor will be act like a switch. So it is connected in between plus 5 volt to this point. This is IC555. It is used in a stable mode where it will generate the frequencies. But this particular transistor's action, it will mix the circuit with a different frequency. You can see here, this is RA, this is RB, and this is capacitor C. So it will generate a frequency 1.44 divided by RA plus 2 times RB into C. So this RA and this RB and this C. So this C is fixed. We can say it is a fixed. This RB, 47 kilo ohm, is also fixed, and this RA is the varying quantity. So why it is varying? Because sometimes there will be only RA and sometimes there will be this switch. So when this switch will be on, when it will be a 1, this switch will make the transistor on, and this 50 kilo ohm and this 50 kilo ohm get parallel to each other. So parallel combination makes one resistance called as RA for 1 logic 1, and there will be a second resistance RA just for logic 0. So this is, we can say, RC parallel RA for logic 1 and RA for logic 0. It will make the mark and space frequency. So what we have to do, we have to do the calculation. So which frequency we want by using this frequency formula. So you can see here the circuit used to generate the FSK modulated waveform. So we have seen. So it is built using 555 as a stable multivibrator and square pulses that are fed from this side. So a 1 0 1 0 pulses will be fed. Then it will generate FSK output according to this circuit's operation. If we have to generate the square pulses, we need to add another one 555 circuit, so it will produce the square waveforms. So this working is very easy to understand. The output of this 555 is based on the digital signal that is fed over here. So that will mix this transistor on and off and will have two frequency called as mark and space. So this RA and this RC will play important role. When RA is parallel to RC, it will give you another one resistor for logic 1 and RA for logic 0. So we can have a formula F is equal to 1.45 RA plus 2RB into C. So if you have to get the frequency 1070, we need to choose RA, RB and C. So for 1070, we need to do the calculation depending upon this. So we have to put the frequency as 1070. Capacitor is a fixed quantity. RB is a fixed quantity. Find out RA. So we have to find out RA. So RA may be, it will be a 50 kilo ohm. Then and then only we'll have a 1070. So now to have a 1270, that is called as a mark frequency. So at that time there will be a logic 1 fade to this. This transistor becomes on and we have RA parallel RC. So you know 50 into 50 divided by 50 plus 50, that will leads to 50 into 50 is a 2500 100. So 25 kilo ohm will be the resistance. So it will create a frequency of 1270. So this RC is added in addition to RA. So it will have a resistance called a 25 kilo ohm, and this will make the charging and discharging of this capacitor faster. So it will increase the waveform as a 1270. So the values of the resistors and this capacitor will tell us to select the frequency of 1270. So we can have a frequency formula like this. So it will create 1270 hertz. So the output of FSK will be 1070 when the input is high and 1270 when the input is low. So in this way we can have frequency shift keying, where 1270 and 1070, this will be generated. Thank you for listening my lecture. Please subscribe my channel for more videos. Thank you.